This is a demo of File Upload Forms, a form builder that's integrated right into Google Sheets. With File Upload Forms, you can accept files from anyone. They don't have to sign into their Google accounts, and they can upload files of virtually any size as long as there's space in your Google Drive. Now, before I get into the implementation, let me show you a simple form that's built using File Upload Forms. Now, if you would like to try this yourself, just go to formstudio/demo and you can fill this form yourself. So this is a simple job application form where applicants can upload their resumes, fill in their details, and they can even e-sign the form before submission. So let's quickly fill this form. For the resume field, we have set a restriction that only PDF documents are allowed, so you can see that all the other files are non-selectable when the user is trying to upload a file. So here we have another file upload field that allows multiple files, but the restriction is that only image formats are supported. So you can upload GIFs, PNGs, and JPEGs, but no other format. Finally, I'll solve the captcha puzzle and then hit this green button to submit my form. So the form is submitted and as you can see, you get a confirmation message, and this is also personalized. So if you remember the name I put in the form, it's now appearing in the confirmation message as well. Now let's open the Google Sheet that's storing these responses. So all the data that I entered in the form is now available as a new row in this spreadsheet. And if I go to my Google Drive, you can see that all the files that were uploaded through the form are also available in this folder. So now that you know how file upload forms work, let's quickly build one from scratch. So to get started, go to forms.studio/copy and make a copy of this Google spreadsheet template into your Google Drive. I'll also put all these links in the video description. Now this is the Google Sheet that will be storing all our form responses. First, let's quickly rename this sheet to say, let's say applications. Next, before we design the form, we need to publish this script so that others would be able to use our form via a simple web link. So for that, go to Tools and then choose Script Editor. Now this is the place where all the Google script code goes. So you don't have to fiddle with the code, don't worry about that, you just have to publish this. So for that, go to the Publish menu and then choose Deploy as Web App. Now just give your form version some name. Next, under the Execute as App section, you need to choose Me, because you want people to upload files in your Google Drive rather than their own. Next, under the Who has access to the app, choose Anonymous, because you want anyone to be able to upload files to your Google Drive without having to sign into their Google accounts. Now, if you remember, Google Forms also have file uploads option, but the big limitation is that respondents need to be signed into their Google accounts in order to upload files. Now, you don't have any such limitation with file upload forms. So click on Update and you may be required to authorize the form. since it has to do all the operations like sending emails and uploading files on your behalf? Now, if you see this app not verified screen, just click on the advanced link and then choose go to file upload forms. Google has recently changed some of their policies, and each app has to be manually verified by Google before this warning goes away. So I'll put a link in the video description where you can submit your script to Google and this warning would be removed. So our script is now authorized, and that's pretty much it. You have to do this only once. So we'll close the script editor and switch to the Google Sheet to design the form. So while you're inside the Google Sheet, go to the File Upload Forms menu. Now this is just next to the Help menu, and choose Edit Form. Now this will open up the form designer that's integrated right into your Google Sheets. So it has some dummy fields in the form builder. I'll just remove them and start building the form from scratch. Let's say we are trying to build a form similar to the application job applications form. So we'll add a name field and make it a required one. Now we'll add a phone number field and make this required as well. And we'll use some regular expressions to add validations to this field. Now regular expressions require a separate tutorial, so I'll put some links in the video description where you can go and learn more about regular expressions. Next, we'll add a file upload field, and here we want to accept only PDF and Word documents. So I'll put PDF, Word in the allow files option. I'll add one more field in the form for file uploads, and this time we will allow users to upload files of different types like images, videos, and so on. Now, instead of specifying different file types, I can just put any, and users would be able to upload files of virtually any type. Next, we'll add an e-signature field. Now, when a user submits the form, this image will be saved as a PNG image in your Google Drive along with the other files. Okay, so our form is nearly complete. Let's hit the preview button to see how it would look like in user's browser. Looks good so far, so I'll show you one more interesting thing, and that is the rich HTML field. This field allows you to embed virtually anything in your form, from YouTube videos to Google Maps to images to anything that's in HTML. So let me show you an example. So here I am on the Google Maps website, and let me grab the embed code for this place. So I'll copy this HTML and paste it inside the rich HTML field of my form. Let me embed one more field, a rich HTML field, and this would be for a YouTube video. So this is the embed code for the YouTube video. I can just copy the entire thing and paste it into the form. Okay, all set. Let's hit the preview button and see how these embeds look like in the actual form. So this is how easy it is to embed any content in your form. All set. I'll just remove these rich HTML fields since I don't want them in the final form. And then I'll save my changes. Okay, so my file upload form is now nearly done, but I need to make a few more changes before making this live. So I'll go back to the file uploads menu and choose the configure form option. So this opens up a sidebar in your Google Sheet where you can customize the look and feel and many other aspects of the form. So first I'll expand the basic settings tab and then add a form title. Next, I'll add a form description. So you can use plain text or you can even use HTML tags to add more emphasis. Next, I'll put the confirmation message. Now, this is the text that will be shown to visitors when they submit your form. Now, again, here you can format the text with HTML tags, but you can also personalize your tags with place markers. So for instance, if I have a field called name, I can put name inside the confirmation message and enclose this field inside double curly braces. And when the user submits the form, this place marker, which is inside double curly braces, will be replaced with the actual value that is entered by the user in the form. Next, we have the redirect field. So here I can put a URL of my website or any other page, and the user will be redirected to this website after they submit the form. So you can have either of these things. You can have a confirmation message or a redirect option. I want to show the confirmation message rather than redirect user, so I'll clear the redirect field. So let's now save these settings and proceed to the next section, which is advanced settings. Now, all files that are submitted through your form will be saved into your Google Drive, but you can also decide the folder where those files should go. So let me go to my Google Drive and create a folder. Now, in the Google Sheet, I can choose the folder that I just created. And this will be the main folder where all the files would be saved. You can also have custom folders inside the parent folder, like /folder1, /folder2, and so on. Now, these subfolders can also be customized to include form fields, just like we used place markers with a confirmation message. So for instance, if I want all form entries from a specific city to go into one specific folder, I can use this option. If you have a Google Analytics account, you can put your ID here and track your form open activity inside Google Analytics. I'll keep this blank. If you want to protect your form with a password, just put that down here. Next, you can include a captcha to prevent spam bots from making false submissions. You also have several built-in color schemes to choose from. I'll go with the default green theme. Okay, so I'll save these advanced settings and then proceed to the next section, which is email notifications. So there's a built-in email designer that you can use to visually create your email notifications. So first we'll specify the recipient. Now I can put my own email address here, and a copy of all form responses will be sent to my email address as soon as someone submits the form. But I can also choose to send a copy to the form respondent. So I can put the field where we are asking for the email address, and this will be replaced with the actual value when the user submits a form. For the subject field, again, we can make use of place markers, that is fields enclosed inside double curly braces. Uh, For writing the message body, there's a quick shortcut. So you can type your place markers manually, or you can use this little drop-down to quickly insert fields into your message body. We have a special field called All Answers, and what this will do is it will insert a copy of the form response in a neat HTML table in your email message. And our form is nearly done. So here you have the form URL that you can share with the world, and they will be able to upload files directly into your Google Drive via the form. So here's the new form that we just created. Let's quickly fill this form and see what happens after that. So the form is successfully submitted, and if I go to my Google Sheet, you can see that a new row has been inserted with all the form data. And if I go to my Gmail, you can see that an email has gone out to the form respondent as well. So you may have noticed there is a bar at the top that says this application is not created by Google. Now when you will embed this form into your website, this message will automatically go away. So to give you an example, I'm on the JSBin website where you can quickly create HTML mini pages, and then I'll copy the embed code from the sheet and paste it here. And the bar is now gone. Let's also check our Google Drive to see how the files are stored there. And you can see a new folder has been created based on the city that was entered by the user, and a new folder inside that for their email address. So that's pretty much it. If you want to make any changes to the design of the form or to the settings, just go to the Google Sheet and change anything and save it. So for instance, if I want to change the color scheme from green to say blue, I can simply change it and go back to my form, and there you can see the new change has been applied instantly. Thanks.